Okay, student, on the 7th March 2021, you have conducted MCQ test for the course 201. And I was really happy because when I shared answer key of the 201 MCQ test, and students were discussing about the answers. So it reflect that about their studies. Okay. And today I'm going to discuss with you about the MCQ test questions. Okay. So it will help you for your prelim examinations and for the final examinations also. Okay.
ओके मैम,
जस्ट वेट फॉर वाइल. Okay, screen is visible to everyone. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay, who will read the first questions? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Please.
Question one. Post-event analysis includes dash. Option A, taking feedback from participants. Option B, thank all the volunteers for their services. Then option three, evaluation of the result. And option D, all the above.
Okay, so which answer is correct?
All of the above.
Okay, see, because if we see the state different stages, or what we can say, the steps of the event analysis, the post-event analysis is the last stage of the event analysis. Okay, so it includes all these things. In the post-event analysis, we are taking feedback from the participants, we are showing our gratitude towards all the volunteers who have participated for the achievement of that event, and also we evaluate the result. Okay, so whatever we plan, how we are implemented, we evaluate our result of the event, whatever event you have conducted. So it includes all the things in the post-event analysis. Okay, the next question is, yes, which of the following is best strategy for effectively planning out your time? And the options are prioritizing all your tasks, ignore all the unexpected work, delay any unnecessary work. Okay, so here the correct answer is prioritizing all your tasks. So can anyone justify this answer? Yes. Yes, I want interactions from your side.
In prior first option that we need to plan before if we are doing something, then we need to plan before that one in the plan wise like if we are taking any lecture, so we need to plan that lecture in 1.5 hour, sorry, in half hour what we have to take in the half hour. For which time we need to explain how much time that specific time period is there, so that we can cover all the points in the given time period. So the priority is that one, I
See,
think
for
so.
example, suppose we are planning for a day, and in a day we have to do different tasks, we have to complete different tasks. Okay, but here again we have to prioritize our all the tasks for the effective implementation. For example, suppose I am having first lecture today, okay, and I am also having different tasks, but if my lecture is the first, so I have to prepare for that lecture in time, so I have to prioritize my different tasks. Okay, so what should I take for the lecture? Am I prepared for that lecture? Okay, so what kind of resources I'm going to use for the lecture? So as per the priority, I have to complete the task. So here the lecture, that is the first task, and the remaining, as per the priority, I can give the numbers second, third, and fourth, etc. Okay, so here the answer is prioritizing all your tasks. Yes, am I audible? Hello? Hello, am I audible? Let me know, please.
Yes,
Yes,
ma'am.
yes. Okay. The third
Yes,
question
ma'am.
is, see, a subordinate should take order from only one boss and he should be responsible and accountable to him. This Henry Fayol principle is called as. See, while giving answer for any MCQ type questions, first you have to learn how to eliminate the options. Okay. For example, total 14 principles of management given by the Henry Fayol. And here what they are saying, actually the statement is saying that a subordinate should take order only from one boss. And that particular subordinate is responsible and accountable for only one boss. So here the options are unit of direction, unit of command, scalar chain, and authority and responsibility. So first, which option you will eliminate? See, this is one trick how to solve MCQs. Yes, tell me.
Ma'am, scalar chain.
Okay, first we'll eliminate the scalar chain. Okay, then next.
Authority and responsibility.
Very nice, Asta. Authority and responsibility means like it's like a KBC 50-50 lifeline is here. So
Yes, ma'am.
out of these four, we have to select only one. But now what we did, we have eliminated two. That is the scalar chain and authority and responsibility. Now we have only two options with us. That is unity of direction and unity of command. Now tell me what is meaning of unity of direction? See, it is very easy to find out answer of the particular question. So unity of direction means what? Just try to recall the different principles of given by the Henry Fayol. Yes, don't remember anything. Yes, students, I want responses from your side.
Ma'am, unity of direction will be one head, one plan, which he always says.
Unity of direction means to work on the proper planning. There should be planning. For example, at the starting of the academic year, there is an annual plan, and the entire work of the school is going to implement it as per the planning. So that annual plan, or you can say the action plan, it gives direction for the implementation. Okay, that is nothing but the unity of direction. So all are following the particular planning, particular action planning. So automatically, again, we eliminate this option, that is unity of direction. Right, and the last one, that is unity of command, and the meaning of this principle is the subordinate should take order from only one. There is only one superior and subordinate taking order. So whatever superior is telling, so he the subordinate, they are following that particular superior. So here boss is only one, and so that they are responsible and accountable only him. So this is the meaning of this unity of command. So option B, that is you can say the second option. Unity of command, it is the correct option for this question. Understood about this? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then the next is, what is role of a teacher in classroom management? This is very easy. The options are motivator for student, use activity-based teaching methods, use latest technology in the teaching learning. And the last is all of the above. Okay. So can anybody tell me about the what is classroom management? Because most of the time, what we are thinking that when there is a silence in the classroom, there is no noise in the classroom. That is nothing, that particular teacher is good in classroom management. But actually, it is not like that. So what is the exact meaning of classroom management? Yes.
To take students' participation also while teaching, and we should make sure that they are listening us and they are participating with us.
Okay, I want some other answers. Yes.
Ma'am, classroom management is a process where the teacher has to ensure that the classroom runs smoothly.
ओके सी
despite
वो
of any classroom noises or any
इन
disruptive
योर
behavior by the
क्लासरूम कैन यू
students.
से दैट दैट द टीचिंग लर्निंग प्रोसेस रनिंग स्मूथली.
Yes.
ओके सो मोटिवेशन इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट बिकॉज इफ द स्टूडेंट दे आर हैविंग मोटिवेशन दे कैन ईगरली पार्टिसिपेट फॉर द लर्निंग. सो टू गेट इंटरेक्शंस विद द स्टूडेंट्स और टू गेट द इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट इन द लर्निंग सो इट शुड बी एक्टिविटी बेस्ड. एंड अगेन दिस इज टेक्नोलॉजी इज सो अगेन टीचर दे हैव टू यूज द लेटेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजी वाइल टीचिंग लर्निंग. सो द आंसर इज ऑल ऑफ द अबव. ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच इज नॉट एन एलिमेंट ऑफ टाइम टेबल. And the answer is very simple because timetable is not prepared by considering the only one factor, that is whatever answers given here, that is student, teacher, time slots, and parents. So automatically, this is very simple question. So automatically, we eliminate these three first three answers, that is student, teacher, and time slots. And the answer is parents because while preparing timetable, we are not considering element, that is parents. Okay. The next is methods used to organize classroom activities and instructions, creating a happy and productive learning environment are known as. Actually, answer of this question was in previous question. The answer is yes. Answer, I have displayed answers also. The answer is classroom management. Okay. So whenever the teacher is using different methods to organize classroom activities, but different instructions are given, and the main thing is creating happy and productive learning environment. So this is nothing but the classroom management. Okay. If you have any query, please feel free to ask me. Yes, student. Okay. Now it's your turn.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me. See, we have learned the both the concept, that is wastage and stagnation. Okay, so the question is premature withdrawal of children from school at any stage before completion of the primary courses is called as, the answer is wastage. Okay, now tell me, there are two concepts, wastage and stagnation. Okay, so now tell me, what is stagnation? Yes.
Stagnation means when students fail continuously in one particular class.
Okay, stagnation यानी एक जगह से रुक
stop
जाना.
there.
Yes, अगर student किसी भी एक class में बार बार fail होता है, for example, suppose the particular year, suppose the student is in the fifth standard and he is going to fail in the same class. So एक साल का जो भी standard है उसको complete करने के लिए उसको ज्यादा साल लगते हैं, that is nothing but the stagnation. Okay. So see the difference between premature withdrawal of the child from the school at any stage before completion of the primary courses. So just forget about the primary courses. Before completion of the any academic year, for example, fifth standard, it is for the one academic year. But before completion of the fifth standard, if the particular child is going to withdraw from the school because of any reason, okay, then that is the condition of the wastage. And when any student is getting fail in the particular class again and again, that is the example of the stagnation. Okay. Yes. Now again, it's your turn. You have studied records and registers. Okay. So all financial transactions of the school occurring from day to day is entered in. So options are stock register, service book, log book, cash book. Yes.
Cash book.
Of course,
for the financial things only.
Yes, can you tell me? Yes, can you tell me about the what is entered? What entries are done in the stock register, service book, and log book? Yes.
Yes, in stock register, how much stock is remaining in the school, that we can mention here, and what stock we had used till date. So that one is again mentioned in the stock register.
Okay, what about the service book? It is for whom?
It is for teachers.
Okay.
Their service records are maintained.
It is not for the principal. It is not for the principal.
It's for the teachers. For teachers, the staff.
Yes, it is for, we can say, the teaching staff, we can say. Then what about the logbook? Yes.
Ma'am, to register any remarks or like any observations, any improvements.
Yes, so whatever activities teacher is conducting in the classroom regarding anything, regarding teaching, learning, so everything is entered in the logbook, okay? And the answer is, any if the thing is regarding any financial transaction, it is entered in the cash book. Then question number 9. See, always there are chances to ask questions on the leadership styles. Okay, and most of the time students are getting confused between mostly the autocratic and democratic, and I observe the same thing in the WhatsApp chat also. In which type of leadership, decision making is completely in the hand of followers? Yes. So basically, if we see the types or styles of leadership, there are 3 styles of leadership: autocratic, democratic, and the third is delegative. There are other names also. You have to remember other names, because autocratic, it is also called as, yes, autocratic. The other name for autocratic, you should know the different names.
Authoritarian, ma'am.
Yes,
authoritarian.
Very good, Shubhangi. Authoritarian. For democratic, yes, participative. And third is delegative. There is another word for delegative style. Yes.
Free leadership style.
The fancy word is lazy fair. Okay. That is delegative.
Yes.
You should remember all the words. Okay. See, in which type of leadership, decision making is completely in the hands of follower? And the answer is yes.
Delegative.
Yes, delegative. That is the correct answer.
Lazy.
Yes, that is another word for the delegative. Lazy spare. Very good.
Lazy.
Okay. This is a very challenging question. This is very simple but challenging question for you. Which of the following is not the academic need? We have studied about the infrastructure resources, and we have divided the infrastructure resources into, that is, the human needs and academic needs. And
yes,
read...
I have doubt in that question. Means, I thought it will be museum, but how come it's classroom? Means...
See,
I think classroom is the basic need for the academy.
See, read the question carefully. I have written the word that is not.
Yes,
which of the following
so it
is
it could be museum,
not...
ma'am, right?
The answer,
no,
see, no, no. The answer is, the correct answer is classroom. Because, see, so whenever things are related to comfort, so what comes under the human needs, your infrastructure, in infrastructure, you are the site of the building, the location, even the building structure, the classroom, canteen, parking, all, everything is comes under the human needs. But remaining things like the laboratory, okay, and the classroom, they also comes under the human needs. And the remaining things like laboratory, libraries, museums, the remaining things comes under the academic needs. And here the question is, which of the following is not academic need? So here you have to think about the human need, and the classrooms, they comes under the human need. That's the reason this classroom is the answer of this question. Understood about this? See, the everything we are using for the learning. Classroom mein hum physically pehle bhi hum log learn karte the. Just think about the some centuries before. Wahan pe classrooms nahi hote the, lekin learning hota. But nowadays, though, if we divide the infrastructure in the 2 parts, academic and the human needs, the classroom comes under human needs. The comfort classroom comes under human needs. But we require library, we require computer room, we require laboratory, the museum, everything comes under the academic needs. The answer is the classroom for this question. Okay? Yes or no?
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, but I still have a doubt,
okay,
that now, considering the current situation, the pandemic situation that we have, I think the schools continue doing their teaching learning process without the museum, without going outside the school, or without going outside the online classroom as well.
See, so here, online just forget about the pandemic situation, because see, if the lectures and everything is going on virtually, na, then there is no need of the infrastructure or the building and whatever things are included in the building and location or site, whatever things are included there. So there is no need of that. So just consider about the physical classes. जनरली रेगुलरली जैसे क्लासेस होते थे वैसे ही आप कंसिडर कीजिए, उसी की अकॉर्डिंगली हमें सोचना है. डोंट कंसिडर अबाउट द पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन. ओके,
यस शुभांगी, यू मीन टू से दैट द एकेडमिक नीड एज इन जनरल यू आर सेइंग, एंड यू आर नॉट सेइंग, ओह सॉरी, यू आर सेइंग इट इज रिलेटेड टू द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर एंड नॉट एज इन जनरल. Because academics, जब हम बोलते हैं, so first thing what comes to mind is school,
academic
and
human
and
needs.
Other things.
See, academic and human needs both are the type. Both these are the two types of the infrastructure. So whatever infrastructure we are having, we are going to divide the infrastructure in the two parts. That is human needs and academic needs. So even see the quarters for the teachers, they comes under the human needs. And again, they included the classroom also in the human needs. Because, yes. For example, suppose we are going to take for the student for the field visit. Okay, so that field visit, that can be visit to museum also, right? Are you getting my point?
Right.
Okay.
Yes. So,
see, again, I'm telling you, first you have to learn about the elimination of the whatever options are there, elimination of the options. So here automatically, आपने तो पहले ये दो options तो पहले निकाल दिए. आपका problem क्या था? आपको confusion है in between the museum and the classroom. Again, you have to think about the both the things, museum and classroom. और अगर दोनों में आप compare करोगे तो finally, automatically you will eliminate the museum because the question is not the academic need. Okay, so according to this, the answer is classroom. Understood about this? Should I move ahead? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, this is very simple question. We have learned different theories of management, and in our syllabus there are only two theories: Henry Fayol theory and Peter Drucker's theory. Which of the following observation is not a part of Peter Drucker's work? And the answer is automatically. The answer is. The scientific management, because if we see there are different names for the Peter Drucker's theory. Yes, do you remember the names of the Peter Drucker's theory? Because again they will ask questions by using different names of the Peter Drucker's work or Peter Drucker theory. So the second name is, that is management by objectives. This is another name for Peter Drucker's theory. Okay, which of the following observation is not a part of Peter Drucker's work? You have to see, every time you have to read the question carefully, you have to understand the question carefully. Again, the not a part of Peter Drucker's work. If we see this theory, it is also called as management by objective, and more emphasis is given on the objective, or we can say the achievements of the objective. See, you can see here the guidelines are given to achieve the goals. So if we find the odd man out, automatically scientific management, it is the odd thing from these four options. Okay, so answer is the scientific management. Actually, the scientific management theory, it is given by the Taylor, that is the new theorist. Actually, previously, if you see the previous syllabus of the B.Ed, I think before 2015 pattern, that this theory, it is included in the course 201, but now they have eliminated this theory. Okay. The next is, okay, now this is your turn. A teacher can develop social values among students by, yes, which is the correct answer?
Ma'am, I have written here behave ideally. Matlab, by seeing the teacher only, the students will follow this thing.
Lekin
like
uske liye kitna time lagega aap behave ideally behave karne ke liye aapko? Matlab, waise hote hote bachche shayad ho sakte ki school se bahar nikal jayenge wo. ओके, सो यहाँ पे भी आपको, हाँ यहाँ पे भी आपको इलिमिनेशन फैक्टर यूज करना है. सी, हर बार ये तो पॉसिबल नहीं है. डेवलपिंग सेंस ऑफ डिसिप्लिन. ओके, यहाँ पे हो सकता है मेरे हिसाब से यहाँ पे दो, पहले सेकेंड एंड थर्ड ये पहले इलिमिनेट हो जाएंगे. उसके बाद दो ऑप्शंस बचते हैं, टेलिंग देम अबाउट द ग्रेट पीपल एंड टेलिंग देम अबाउट द गुड स्टोरीज. सी स्टोरीज, स्टोरीज के बहुत सारे टाइप्स है, तो यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा वो स्कोप थोड़ा ये हो जाता है, मतलब अलग हो जाता है. यहाँ पे टेलिंग देम अबाउट ग्रेट पीपल्स, तो जो भी ऑलरेडी पीपल्स है उनके बारे में. सी बिकॉज ना द स्टूडेंट्स दे आर इमिटेटिंग इमिटेटिंग डिफरेंट लीडर्स, तो यहाँ पे हम लोग स्टोरीज हम बोलेंगे यहाँ पे. तो हिस्ट्री की स्टोरीज बोल सकते हैं, जो भी अभी जो आइडियल्स है उनकी स्टोरीज बोल सकते हैं. सो इट हेल्प्स अस टू डेवलप सोशल वैल्यूज अमंग द स्टूडेंट्स. ओके, सो आंसर इज टेलिंग देम अबाउट ग्रेट पीपल. ओके, द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज अकॉर्डिंग टू हेनरी फियोल द फ्लो ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन इज अ डैश डैश प्रोसेस एंड द ऑप्शंस आर टू वे, वन वे, रिवर्स एंड ऑल डायरेक्शनल. सो नाउ जस्ट रिकॉल ऑल द प्रिंसिपल्स गिवन बाय द हेनरी फियोल. यस
Yes, ma'am. It should be one way.
It should be one way. It comes under which principle, yes. Shubhangi?
Ma'am, authority. Unity See. Of.
No.
Command. Can we say
command?
Just recall the scalar chain. It comes under the scalar chain. So it tells about the flow of communication. Okay. According to Henry Fayol, there should be flow of communication is always from the top to bottom. So it is one way process of communication. The next is overcrowded class is the main cause for. Yes, the answer is total there are four options: adjustment problem, emotional problem, disciplinary problem and concentration problem. Actually we have studied this in the in discipline in the school. Okay, so overcrowded class, it is the main cause for the disciplinary problem, or we can say the indiscipline in the school. Okay, which old tradition is a cause of wastage? So first we know the what is wastage. Wastage means what? Premature withdrawal of a child before completion of the particular course, or you can say any grade. Okay, so that is nothing but the wastage. So what are the causes of wastage? Just read all the options. Child marriage, education should not be given to girl child, girls have to take care of their younger siblings. Okay, so and the last is all of the above. So according to you, which option is correct? I have displayed the option that is all of the above. Is it correct or not?
Yes ma'am, correct.
Okay,
yes ma'am, it is correct.
Why teachers training is necessary? Increase teaching skills, understand methods of school organization, upgrade knowledge of the content. Yes. Now you are in pre-service teacher training, then you can give answer of this question, and the answer is all of the above.
All of the above.
Okay, good. Okay, the timetable is defined as dash dash within which the work of the school proceeds, and the options are chart, mirror, framework, and none of the above. Now it's your turn. Tell me the answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Mirror.
Ma'am, it should be framework.
No, mirror.
Who is saying mirror. That it is framework?
I'm Shubhangi.
Okay, Shubhangi. Actually, by mistakely, I have written the answer mirror, but the actual answer is the framework, because this is the definition. Timetable is defined as framework within which the work of the school proceeds. This is the definition given by the HD state. Okay, so as per the definition, the correct answer is the framework. Okay, and there is another definition, ma'am. That is, it is defined as the mirror that reflects the entire educational program followed in the school. If the definition is this, then the answer is mirror. But according to the definition, the correct answer is framework. Okay, very good, Shubhangi. Okay, again, we have. See, Which of the following decision procedures would be characterized by the manager who asks other people for their opinions and ideas and then makes the decision alone? And the answer is?
Yes. And democratic, because here the leader takes the opinions, considers them, and then the decision is made by himself.
Okay. Any other answer from your side? Because some students, they are saying that this is autocratic style. So can you justify? Yes. Yes, student.
Ma'am, I think everybody believes that it is democratic.
Okay. So, can you tell me what is the difference between the democratic and autocratic? Yes.
Ma'am, in autocratic, the leader dictates his policies or the rules or the decision that he's making.
Decision that is?
That he's going to take. So he dictates basically.
In democratic, what the leader is doing, in democratic, leader is...
Ma'am, autocratic or democratic?
See, in democratic, leader is asking subordinates for the opinions and the ideas, and the final decision is taken by the leader only. That is nothing but the democratic. But in autocratic, leader is not asking anything to the subordinates. Alone, he is taking decision. That is autocratic. Okay? Understood or not? And in delegative, the entire...
Can we take the example of China and India?
Yes, of course. Yes, very nice example you are given. Because in India, it is the democratic country, and the what about China? See, again, there is difference between the autocratic and the bureaucratic. So I think that China, instead of autocratic, China comes under bureaucratic. So do you know the meaning of bureaucratic? Yes?
Yes, ma'am. People don't have their opinions.
In bureaucratic, in bureaucratic, there is only bossing around the people.
Bossing, yes. The rulers have all the
rights.
Yes. And so they decide for all the...
Yes, so I think China comes under bureaucratic country. Okay? See, student, only we have 1 minute, and again I will share another link for you. So please join immediately. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
A student comes late in your class, then you will. The options are inform to parents, punish him, try to know the reason, not pay attention there.
Try to know the reason is correct.
Okay.
Yes.
This is the right answer. That is try to know the reason.
Okay. Let's move towards the next question. That is, accreditation in education is the process by which an association or agency evaluates and finally recognizes it as having met and satisfied or exceeded certain predetermined requirements and criteria or standards of educational quality. So, which is the correct answer? So, there are four options: educational institution, program of the study, and the school. And the correct option is all of the above, because accreditation, any institution goes for the accreditation, schools, they are also going for the accreditation. And here, the meaning of the program of the study means any kind of program. For example, we'll take example of our institution, MIT. It is an institution. And the B.Ed. course, it is a program of a study. So alone, any program, for example, B.Ed. program, it goes for the accreditation. But there are different agencies for the accreditation. We have already studied that NABED, which comes under Quality Council of India, that is QCR. So that NABED comes under QCR, is the agency for the school accreditation. And for the higher education, for example, for education institutions, and the program of the study, there are the other agencies like NAC. So for this question, the correct answer is all of the above. Then the next question is, why teacher training is necessary? So here we can think about the pre-service and in-service training, but consider general training for the teachers. So options are increase teacher skill, or we can say increase teaching skill, understand methods of school organization, upgrade knowledge of the content, and the last is all of the above. And the correct answer is, what do you think that, which is the correct answer? Yes, the last answer, that is all of the above, is the correct answer. Because all the three, about three things are important, the teaching skill, there should be increase in the teaching skill, and that's the reason training is necessary to understand different methods of the school organization, because as a part of that organization, teachers should understand different methods of school organization. There should be upgradation of the knowledge of the content, or we can say the upgradation of the content knowledge. So the answer is all of the above. Then the next question is, authority and responsibility are dash-dash to each other. So here, authority and responsibility are dash-dash to each other. The options are supplementary, contradictory, complementary, and none of the above. The correct answer is, of course, it is not supplementary. We can use the elimination factor. Then it is not contradictory. Then the last answer, the second last, is complementary. So the complementary answer is the correct for the question 22, that is authority and responsibility are complementary to each other. Then next question is, selecting one course of action among various alternatives is, see, there are four options: decision making, planning, organizing, coordinating. This is very simple one. See, here we have to select one course of action among various alternatives. So this is all about the decision making. So option one, this is the first option, it is the correct one. Yes, question number 24. Fields functions of management include. Just recall all the functions of management, but the question is only about the functions of management told by the Henry Fayol. So Henry Fayol's functions of management, it includes, there are different options. Option number one, it includes the planning, designating, completing, cooperating. The second, punishing, commanding, organizing, coordinating, controlling. The third, preparing, commanding, operating, consulting, controlling. And the last one, that is planning, commanding, organizing, coordinating, controlling. When we have studied the concept of management, in that we also studied one definition of management given by the Henry Fayol. In that definition, Henry Fayol focuses on to manage means, see, to manage means to forecast, to plan, to command, to organize, to control, and to coordinate. See, but here I have written only the five functions of management given by the Henry Fayol. We can add one more function, that is the forecasting. So the last option, that is the correct option for this question. So the answer is planning, commanding, organizing, coordinating, and controlling. And the last question, that is dash dash, is the quality of a teacher. If we see options, so we have to find out the primary options, because if we see all the options, they are correct, because all these are the qualities of the teacher. Teacher should have good control over the emotion. Teacher should have good command over the subject. He should have sense of humor. She should have good physical health. All these are the qualities. Some qualities are the personal qualities. Some qualities are the professional qualities. But here we have to consider about the primary quality. So after thinking about the primary quality, automatically you can eliminate the option 1, 3, and 4, and the final answer will be good command over the subject. Okay, so this is all about the MCQ questions and answer discussion. We have discussed which is the correct answer for the particular MCQ. I hope this will help you for your prelim examination and for also for the final examination. You can say the university examination. Okay. Now I'm going to stop here. See you soon with the new content in the next lecture. Thank you.